Sorry about that. I had to get my laptop because I need to inform you guys about the Elite Four's Pokemon's moves, just as I did way back in Black and White, or Pokemon Black, rather. Four trainers. Every Pokemon League in every region all over the world features four fantastic trainers called the Elite Four. Here in Alola, too, we've got four trainers all lined up for our Pokemon League. You'll win your way past every last one of them. You can't leave until you do. Or until you give up. Sounds good. You know the drill by now, guys. Incineroar, Plague, can sense when his trainer is nervous. Stay loose, you'll be fine. I expect you to show me some intense moves and real heart-stopping battles in there. Good luck, Cottonmouth, and Plague. I really like this room. It's like a huge cave. Just in the middle of a mountain. So, in Pokemon Black and White, or Pokemon Black, sorry, I did the Elite Four from right to left, because most people tend to do it from left to right. I'm gonna do it the same old way I did it before, right to left. I considered doing it least favorite to favorite, but I decided I love these Elite Four people so much, I can't decide which one's my favorite, and heck, an even tougher decision, who's my least favorite. I don't dislike any of them. So we're starting off right here. This green room. Loving this place, all the green everywhere. So, here you are. Why don't we see who the winds favor today? You or me? Finally! Finally! We have a flying type Elite Four member. As a fan of flying types and birds in general, I am super excited for this. Got Incineroar in the front. We're ready to duel. My name is Kahili. A few years ago, I was a champion of the Island Challenge 2, just like you. I've been traveling the world to improve my skill as both a trainer and as a golfer. When I heard they made a Pokemon League in my own home region, I came flying back to serve Alola. Have a look at my fantastic flying-type team. Cue the music. Ugh, shivers down my spine every time. Elite Four Kahili, 5 Pokemon. Starting with Skarmory. Steel and flying type. Its moves are Slash, according to my information that is, Slash, Steel Wing, Feint, and Spikes. Oh dear, entry hazards. I made the right decision teaching my dear Sarina how to use Rapid Spin. And there we go, starting off with the Spikes. Give the old flamethrower. And Sturdy is a thing. This music, holy crap, it just might be my favorite Elite Four music of all time. Heck, it might even be my favorite soundtrack in this entire game. And yeah, I know I already said that about the Aether Foundation and their battle music, but this is just so good. Sturdy again. And we burned Skarmory. Oh, I love this. Plague, you might be bad luck in Miraculous, but you're pretty good luck here in Pokemon Moon. Mandibuzz. Great. Mandibuzz. This thing always seems to like giving me a hard time. Actually, you know what? We'll go with legs. I know, suicide, right? But I gotta get rid of that entry hazard. So I think legs will be my sacrificial Pokemon. As cruel as that is to say. But we want to rapid spin these spikes away. So, anyway, Mandibuzz is a dark flying type. Its moves are Flatter, Bone Rush, Brave Bird, and Punishment. Punishment might do a bit of damage, especially considering how it buffs you with the old Flattery. But legs served her purpose. I'm bringing in the Edgelord. Whatever this vulture uses. Yep, Brave Bird, I suspected as much. He is going to tank it like a champ because of the disguise ability. Sorry, Mandibuzz. Takes no recoil, but I don't care. Time to play roughly with it. And it's flattering us. I appreciate the flattery, but what I don't appreciate is the confusion. This is why I dislike this Mandibuzz. I mean, it's great that we finally have an Elite Four member using Mandibuzz after Grimsley didn't use it in Black and White. But still, nice to see Mandibuzz, even if it is the most annoying member on our team. Recoil. Come on, Edgelord. Break through that confusion. I believe in you. There we go. That's your second Pokemon. Three more to go. Leg has got some experience. I'm glad for that. Holy crud, Toucannon. Bringing out the big guns, no pun intended. It's a normal flying type, so that means Thunderclap is the way to go. Ah, Toucannon, you're such a badass. So, Toucannon, normal flying type, as I said, moves Beak Blast, Screech, Bullet Seed, and Rock Blast. It actually has the Skill Link ability, so if it's using Rock Blast, then it's going to hit all five times. It's also got the Flynium Z attached to it, so you're going to be seeing some Z moves if you use a Pokemon that's weak or neutral against flying. Starting things off with a Relevation Dance. Hopefully we can knock it out in one hit. Otherwise, I foresee some rocks in my future. Okay, no, it's beginning with Screech to lower my defenses. So that Rock Blast is a guaranteed one-shot. Or five-shot, rather. Another full restore. So at first, when I first met Kahili, I thought, she's a flying-type user. Why is she a golfer? I mean, wouldn't it be more appropriate for her to be an archer? Because in archery, you gotta deal with, like, wind currents and stuff like that. But then I remembered, when you're a golfer, there are all kinds of golfing terms that have to do with birds. Got birdie, eagle, albatross. Not too sure on that last one. I think so. I'm not a golfer. But I never noticed that, but it's a hilarious pun. And she's got a team full of birdies. No Braviary, unfortunately, because then she'd have an eagle. All right, so Toucannon got defeated, no problems whatsoever. Smidvarg's at level 57 right now. Speaking of Smidvarg, we're going to send him in for this next one. This Oricorio, it's the Flamenco Dancer, so it's a fire and flying type. So, moveset. We've got Relevation Dance, Teeter Dance, Feather Dance, and Air Slash. Be funny if the last move was some kind of dance, like, I don't know, Dragon Dance. It'd be great if Oricorio could just learn all of the dance moves, even though it's not a dragon, or a butterfly, because, you know, Quiver Dance. Okay, Aqua Tail is the more accurate of the two moves. Let's hit it with everything we've got. Hopefully Feather Dance doesn't provide too much of an issue. It did not. That Oricorio still got destroyed. Good going, Smidvarg. Leveling up all the time. Crobat, we just got finished seeing this guy under ownership of our good pal Gladion. Crobat, poison flying type. Air Slash, Swift, Supersonic, and Poison Fang. I have no idea why it has Supersonic when it's definitely high-leveled enough to use Confuse Ray. However, the whole accuracy issue with Supersonic doesn't seem to trouble Kahili, because every time I fought her, Supersonic always hits. Like, it never not hits. So, alright. I think we can go for a Flare Blitz here, just try to one-shot it. Oh, that's probably the first time I've seen Supersonic miss. Which is funny, because it only has 50% accuracy. Flare Blitz, oh my god, this is overpowered. And there we go. It's frustrating to me as a member of the Elite Four, but it seems your strength is the real deal. Disappointing to hear the end of that music, but we can hear it three more times, so don't fret. You know, I think you'll bring a breath of fresh air to the Alola battle scene. I was honestly annoyed when Kukui kept pestering me to come here, but I'm glad I did. Alright, let's get out of here. It's time for our next fight, but first we gotta heal up. One out of four down. Really looking forward to this. Healing items, yes. Super potions for Plague. Legs. And Edgelord as well. Don't have any regular... I do have Sweethearts, actually. I can use that to finish up Edgelord. So, let's see what we've got next. Nuru! You didn't get to shine at all last time. So we'll make sure to remedy that. Next room? You guys, I think you'll be surprised to see who's on the other side of this door. Recognize that hair? It's none other than the cute ghost girl herself, Acerola. If it wasn't for Kahili, I think she would without a doubt be my favorite member of the Alola Elite Four. I seem to have a thing for cute Elite Four members, because I remember telling you that Caitlyn was my favorite of the Unova Elite Four. Alright, Acerola. Nanu said maybe he can't refuse a Tapu choosing him to serve as Kahuna, but he'd be darned if he had to serve as one of the Elite Four just because some guy asked him. Oh, Nanu. So I guess I'll just have to battle hard enough to make up for his not being here. That is so new, but it gives us an opportunity to fight cute little Acerola.
Aww, that smile. She's such a cutie.
How you've got competition. Anyway, starting off with Sableye. It is Dark Ghost type, meaning its only weakness is Fairy. Its attacks are Shadow Claw, Zen Headbutt, Confuse Ray, and Fake Out. I am predicting a Fake Out. There we go. It's probably going to use Confuse Ray next. Come on, one-shot it with that Dazzling Gleam. There we go. This music is really tense and menacing, and it makes you feel like it's an uphill battle, but for some reason it just fits Acerola just as much as the other three members of the Elite Four. Maybe it's because she has ghosts? I don't know. Froslass is next. You can probably guess who I'm using next. Plague, my man. I'd say he's my boy, but that's Guzma. Froslass, Ice Ghost type. Blizzard, Shadow Ball, Confuse Ray, Ice Shard. Wide variety of moves. Acerola clearly knows what she's doing. Starting off with Blizzard. Don't see why you'd do that. I mean, I would have gone for the Confusion. But I'm not complaining. A Darkest Lariat should take care of Froslass. It is not the most offensive Pokemon in the world. Not by a long shot. I've always liked using Froslass. I've always thought she was an interesting and useful Pokemon. Plus, there's the whole lore of her hunting people and freezing them and putting them on display in her secret ice cave. It's creepy as heck, I tell you. So, Palossand. Yes. One of the new ghosties from Alola. I love how it rises up out of the ground there. It's so cool. Palossand, Ghost Ground type, Shadow Ball, Earth Power, Giga Drain, Iron Defense. Its held item is the Ghostium Z. So we're probably going to see a Ghost-type Z-Power. But I'm faster than it. So Trop Kick, maybe? Okay, its defenses are clearly more than I bargained for. And it's a special attacker, not a physical attacker. We're going to see a Z-move. Oh dear. Not the Z-move. Never-ending nightmare. Oh my god, legs. Medic! Gotta heal. Where's my hyper potion? There's my hyper potion. Unfortunately, hyper potions got nerfed. Which is very, very unfortunate. Shadow Ball. The next one probably won't KO. So we'll go for another Trop Kick. I'm cool with that. She's probably going to use another healing item on it. I don't like that one bit. So Trop Kick again. I might have to switch out here. Or maybe not. That was a critical hit. Because she loves me so much. I love you too, Legs. You've become like family to me after all this time. Isn't that the whole point of Pokemon Refresh? To make your Pokemon just feel that much closer to you? Anyway, it paid off. Palossand is going back to the depths from which it came. And speaking of depths, we got something else rising up from the grave. I think Thunderclap should handle this one. Dhelmise. I love this thing's design. I've used it before, and it is a beast. I had so much fun with Dhelmise. It learned such a cool variety of moves. Unfortunately, Acerola is not using this Dhelmise properly. It is a ghost grass type. It has the moves Whirlpool, Energy Ball, Shadow Ball, and Slam. Whereas at level 54, it probably could have had Anchor Shot, Shadow Claw, and a bunch of other cool, really good moves. At least that's what my Dhelmise had. Fortunately, I do know that when you rematch Acerola, her Dhelmise does have a proper moveset. Its ability is actually Steel Worker, which increases the power of Steel-type moves. Basically gives it extra stab. It's a physical attacker, not a special attacker. So, fortunately, that Shadow Ball would hurt even more if it had been a Shadow Claw. Or even worse, a Phantom Force. Thunderclap, keep it up. There we are. Finally, we've got Drifblim. And I think... Well, I've got my own ghost to take care of this guy. Edgelord, show him what a real ghost is like. Show them how spooktacular you are. Anyway, Drifblim, ghost flying type. Its moves are Focus Energy, Amnesia, Baton Pass, and Ominous Wind. Yeah, that's it. That's literally all it can do. Baton Pass is useless at this point because it's her only Pokemon left. Amnesia, I don't know why she'd have that on Drifblim. Focus Energy to increase critical hit rate. And Ominous Wind is not that good of a move. So this is like the pushover of her team. Another Shadow Claw for the win. That was a critical hit. Not necessary, but welcomed. Aftermath. Oh, crap. Although it doesn't matter. We've won. Acerola is the second of our two victories. I'm speechless. You've done me in. Whew! Well, there goes my hope of beating you to smithereens and becoming champion myself. Cute little twirl. That's all we'll see of Acerola, at least until we do the rematch.